What's up, guys? It's Grindzilla86 here, and I'm bringing you my next gameplay, which is a, I think it is a 65 and 4 or 64 and 5, something like that, on the map Hijacked. Game mode is Hardpoint. So anyways, I wanted to talk to you guys about a couple different juicy little topics that everyone is kind of in, I don't know, crossroads, or, you know, up in the air about, whatever you want to call it. But anyways, this little beauty right here, this shotgun, the 870, just received a nerf, I believe it's called. I think that's when they ruined the gun. So anyways, about a week or two ago, I noticed I was getting a lot of hit markers, close range, and you'll see it later on in the gameplay. I literally shoot the guy from, like, point blank, like 5 feet away in the chest, hip fire. It gives me a hit marker. I think the guy is dead. I'm on a pretty big street, so I just turn around, you know, run. It actually happens like right here in the other room to the right. But anyways, the guy ends up killing me, and I thought he was dead, and it was just ridiculous how it ended up playing out. And so I started looking up on videos and all, and noticed that there was an update, and that they ruined, look at this nice little quad feet up. Oh, it was triple up. What am I talking about? Anyways, it was nice either ways. But yeah, so they basically ruined the gun, and it was all because of a bunch of YouTubers and a bunch of these little guys that you know, they go on these big streaks. But anyways, everyone's streak was getting ended with this gun, so enough people bitched about it, complained about it, and they ended up, like, ruining the gun, basically. And it's total BS. Every, you know, pump-action shotgun and every Call of Duty has been a one-shot kill from close range. But, yeah, it's just crazy. And also, I wanted to talk to you guys about, or wanted to ask you guys, has anyone else noticed that the lightweight perk, it kind of makes you run, like, weird? Like, I've noticed that, like, whenever I'm running with lightweight on, I kind of, like, slide around. Like, it's almost like I'm, like, running on ice, or, like, ice skating or something. I don't know. It's really strange, but I was just wondering if you guys noticed it too, and if it was just me or the perk or what. But, yeah, and also, the whole new theater mode is kind of ridiculous. There it is, right there. Look at that. Turn around, shoot the guy. Look at this slow-mo. Close range hit marker on his chest. Turn around. I'm like, holy crap, he's not dead. And he kills me. Ugh, it's just crazy. But anyways, yeah, the theater mode keeps losing my matches. Like, I don't know, it just, like, poops out, and, like, the match is gone. So I went, like, 77-2 the other day, called in, like, three sets of swarm. I mean, I was just going ham salad on them. And so anyway, I go back, play, like, three more matches, no host migration, no nothing. You know, the match never ended at all, no migration. And so I go back into the theater mode to try to record the gameplay, and it's not there. And oh man, I almost cried, freaked out, pulled my hair out. Ah man, it was really heart-wrenching. But I mean, and the other things I keep noticing is, like, that when you use any kind of optical sight on basically any weapon, any SMG, any assault rifle, any LMG especially, it seems to give you, like, perfect accuracy. Especially the target finder, that default prestige class with the MK16 with the target finder. Oh man, I pretty much get every one of my streaks ended now by this thing. And I mean, the target finder, it just needs to be taken out of the game. I mean, it's just ridiculous. Like, you know, it highlights you and it gives you, like, perfect accuracy. It's like, you know, do one or the other, you know, like, you know, optic sights shouldn't give you perfect accuracy. And with an LMG, you know, and I'm, you know, in real life, from what I've seen anyway, I've never shot one, but I mean, the guns shoot massive bullets and they have an incredible amount of recoil. You know, no little optic sight, no, you know, grip, anything like that is going to give you this superior, you know, perfect accuracy. And I mean, I know I kind of sound like I'm going on a little rant or whatever, but I mean, after, like, you know, 10 plus 20 20, you know, almost could have been potential nuclear streaks, you know, out the window because, you know, some douche throws on a freaking default, you know, MK16 class and head glitches me from his spawn, and it's just really annoying. But I keep having this problem. I don't know about you guys. It's not really like a problem, but I mean, it seems like basically every match I get into like super tryhard lobbies. Like, it's almost like I'm playing like an MLG pubs or something, and it's just kind of ridiculous. Like, it gets old really fast, and I was just wondering if you guys felt the same way. And I don't know, it's just crazy. A lot of people are in the air about it. A lot of people are reverse boosting, doing all these crazy things to lower your score per minute. But I think I'm gonna make a video on it and show people like the proper way to lower your score per minute, just in case you want to. Because I have noticed, like, on my second account, I play a lot of search and destroy and party games, and I mean, my score per minute isn't really that low on there. It's about like a 250, and I mean, I get into incredible lobbies on that account compared to this one, my main account. I'm about like a 320, 330, something like that, score per minute, which really is not a big difference at all. It's like 70, 80 points of, you know, SPM points. So, but I mean, it's insane. You get into totally different lobbies. I mean, completely different. And it's just a huge, you know, world of a difference. And a lot of guys, they're just, you know, sick of playing against tryhards all the time. I mean, not only that, but, you know, for instance, all right, so about a week ago, I went up against a full clan and I swarmed these guys. I actually got the swarm on a 6-man clan. Tell me why. Every one of them rage quits, the match ends, I lose the gameplay. It's just a total fail, a total loss. So that's the whole problem with, you know, like gameplays now is, you know, even if you get a good gameplay, a good streak against, you know, these tryhard guys, you know, a decent player, he's just gonna leave. And that's like, you know, all there is to it is, you know, if there's a swarm in the air, you know, you're just not gonna stick around for it. And it's just total BS. This, you know, this probationary period crap for rage quitting, just totally, look at that. That was totally redonkulous right there. I shouldn't have opened up the streak, but I really wanted my VTOL and I wanted these last couple kills, but that was my last and final death on there. And I don't know, I was just wondering if you guys felt the same. I mean, it's nice to, you know, get better players and, you know, play competitive lobbies. I mean, I'm all about it. But then at the same time, like I said, you lose gameplays and matches and stuff. You know, no one sticks around for it. So let me know what you guys think in the comments if you enjoyed the video. And I'll be uploading soon. Thanks.